So in the past I've talked about using dictation on your Mac. It's fairly easy, but you can make it much more powerful if you know the special dictation commands that you can use. So first let's turn it on. I'm going to go to System Preferences, and I've already got it turned on, but I'm going to show you how. Under Keyboard, Dictation, and then I've turned it on here. I've turned on Use Enhanced Dictation, and I've set the language, and I've set the shortcut key to pressing the FN key twice, which is the default. So now I can start up dictation really easily by pressing the FN key twice and then talking. Now normally you would just leave this on and just keep talking, keep doing commands. But in order to do the tutorial I'm going to have to turn it off so I can talk to you without it dictating everything that I say. So the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Period. So I tapped the FN key a third time there at the end to turn it off. But normally you would leave it on. Now this works great, except what happens if it doesn't get it right or you want to make a change or something like that. You have to really stop dictating, go to the keyboard, use your trackpad and mouse to do it. Well, there's actually a whole bunch of commands that means you could be completely hands off once you get good at them. So to see these commands you can look at them in two places. One place is you can go to System Preferences, you can go to Accessibility, and then click on Dictation and Dictation Commands. And here's where you can search through them. You can see different ones. You can activate or deactivate them. You can even add custom ones, which I'm not going to go into here. But this isn't the most convenient place to see them. It's easier just to have dictation show you. So I'm going to turn it back on. Show Commands. So you can see that brought up that little list there. That little list, which we're going to look at again here in a second, that will allow you to not only see all the commands, but just the commands that actually work in the situation. So it's really handy. So for instance, let's say that we want to type some more text, but maybe we say something wrong and we just want to undo it. You would use the undo that command. Here is another sentence that I want to type. Undo that. So you can see at the very top of the little microphone floating icon there, you saw the words undo that appear, meaning that it took that as a command and it got rid of what I just said. So that's really handy because a lot of times when you're dictating something you put out a thought, it types it, and then you realize, no, I want to say it in a different way. And the easiest way to actually do that is just to get rid of the entire thing and say it again. It's easy to speak a sentence, so why bother with lots of commands to move the cursor around and select a word and change that word and all of that when you can just speak the sentence again. So that's probably the most important one. But you can also use a series of commands to actually move the cursor around and select text. So watch the list of commands change in different situations. Here is another sentence that I want to type. Move left. Move left. Select previous word. Something else. Select sentence. Move right. Replace something with anything. So you can see there's a bunch of different things that you can do there. You can use move left, move right, move up, move down, and all of that to move the cursor around. You can use the word select with various things like sentence, paragraph. You can say select previous sentence, that kind of thing. And there's all sorts of things. It takes a lot of practice to get used to it. So if you want to use this, what I suggest doing is perhaps just learning them one at a time and adding them to your workflow. So I've actually switched the microphone that dictation uses to a microphone I have that has a mute button. So now we can enable this and it's not going to hear anything I say because the other microphone is muted. So now we can look through this text here and you can see all the different commands here. So there's a lot here under selection for selecting things. There's also a lot here under navigation that you can use. Like go to beginning, go to end, move left, move right, things like that. Then under editing there's a ton of stuff. You saw me use the replace command. You can also use cut, copy, and paste with the word that after it. You can use capitalized, lowercase, all sorts of things. And here's a really important one, the word literal and something after it. So say you want to actually type the words move right. Well, it's going to interpret that as the command to move the cursor right. But if you say literal move right, it will actually put the words move right there. So that's really handy. There's some formatting things here for, you know, bold, italics, underline, that kind of thing. You can even start dictation, stop dictation using your voice. Stop dictation, of course, being the most useful because you can turn this off even if you're activating dictation with the keyboard. Show commands is what I use to bring up this list of commands here. So you've got that. And then you've got a variety of other things that aren't really dictation commands but more just general commands for voice control of your computer. So there's a bunch of different things. One I'm going to leave you with is something that gives you a ton of control over what you can do. And the way you do that is you basically use show numbers and then choose number. So let's say I want to change the font style. So I can do that using the toolbar, but how do I do that with dictation? So I'm going to select everything and then I'm going to use show numbers and choose number to change the font style. Select all. Show numbers. Choose 7. Choose 5. Now you can use the same thing to do anything in the menu. Click Format menu. Choose 2. Choose 2. Thank you.